Mainframes.
What about Microsoft Cloud?
Mainframes are critical to your business. They're secure, reliable, and scalable for all your most important applications and data. To continue to build on this investment, businesses are looking to extend core applications in a hybrid cloud model as part of Microsoft Cloud.
I agree. That's a smart strategy.
Right. By introducing your mainframe developers to Microsoft Cloud, you're leveraging modern tools and removing silos in your development process. Hi, I'm Brian Lang from IBM.
And I'm Shelby Howard from Microsoft.
Today we're going to explain how we're partnering to bring the strengths of both IBM Z and Microsoft Cloud to our clients. Ready?
You bet. So we're already working together by delivering IBM Z and the cloud modernization stack through Azure Marketplace.
Let's walk through a realistic problem that our partnership can solve.
Yeah, so imagine a scenario where a client is a manufacturing client. They have dealerships referencing their part systems, but there's supply chain issues. So those dealerships are actually hitting the IBM Z, looking for parts as they come in because there's a shortage, and they're really hammering the mainframe to get that inventory.
So the IBM Z is really overworked in terms of consumption. It's really delivering a bunch of non-update transactions.
Yeah, and so there's potentially a need for additional capacity, but to solve a short-term issue because it's ideally not a long-term issue with supply chain.
So how do we help this customer solve the problem?
So we're able to add agility by creating an API in Azure and directing that traffic to Azure, and this update happens as the inventory is replenished. So we're timing the update through the API and leveraging Azure API management.
Okay, so now we have an API that's running in the Microsoft Cloud, and it's basically servicing all of the query traffic that's coming from those dealers without impacting the IBM Z. The IBM Z really gets to sit back and relax.
Yeah, exactly. So we're getting the value that the dealerships need, being able to purchase that inventory as it comes up, but we're not driving that consumption on the mainframe.
And the IBM Z is not really sitting back and relaxing. It's driving a bunch of transactions. And obviously one of those transactions is going to be when that inventory gets updated. It now updates the API, feeding the dealership.
But it's a purposeful transaction.
Absolutely. So now that we've got our client developing code in the Microsoft Cloud with the mod stack, they've got an API. Maybe they've expanded that to do multiple APIs. Take us through how they start that process. How do they get there?
Yeah. So the design and develop is actually happening in Azure, leveraging the mod stack.
Okay. So I've got a developer interacting with the mod stack, running in the Microsoft Cloud. I've designed, I've developed it. What's the next step?
Oh, next step is going to be to deploy the API.
Okay, so now I've got that API running in the Microsoft Cloud, again, servicing in between the IBM Z and whatever the end user may be, in this case, our dealership. But really, how does anybody even know that that API has been developed?
So the next step is to expose the API, but you've deployed the API of runtime in Azure. And also one thing to mention here is that the API is leveraging OpenAPI 3 standards.
Okay, so the only reason why we've been able to integrate these things between Microsoft Cloud and IBM Z is because we're all supporting open industry standards. So now we're going to expose that API, correct?
Yes, and you're exposing it leveraging Azure API management. And that gives you consistency across your environment, managing all of your APIs.
Okay. So who are we exposing it to? Obviously, we're exposing it to the dealerships in this example so that they're updating their code, make sure that they're accessing the API as opposed to IBM Z directly. Who else might want access to that API?
Yeah, that's a good point. So we've solved the problem here by exposing the API for this scenario, but that API can also be leveraged for new capability. And let's say the client wants to create a power app using low code, no code, they could also leverage that API in the future.
Okay, so now we're extending that ability. We're taking the investment that a client's had in ModStack and in Microsoft Cloud, extending the value of IBM Z, not only for this problem and solving this problem, but now solving multiple problems and expanding that value into other realms, really. What other use cases do we have that we can talk about with our clients?
So we're talking about APIs. One of the other things to mention about Azure API management is that you also have the ability to deploy security policies using that and control traffic. So having that consistency is key for development across the enterprise. The next thing is actually DevOps. So expanding on development, we can bring the mainframe development into Azure, leveraging the mod stack, and create new capability there too.
So ModStack supports both modern languages. We're talking Java, Go, Node.js, but also COBOL, right? So you can update your ZOS applications using ModStack with your developers running in Microsoft Cloud.
Yes, and going back to the example where we have an API that's exposed to maybe a new application in Azure, you also are removing barriers across Scrum teams by having cloud-native development being done in other areas as well as through the mainframe team.
And again, because it's open industry standards, tied in with Azure DevOps, open industry standards, that code can be written there, the code can be developed there, and then the application can be deployed back to IBM Z and running on the mainframe.
Yeah, and one of the other important things is that you have testing that happens, end-to-end testing in Azure, leveraging a WASI sandbox.
Yeah, so unit testing on there, you're obviously going to bring that back and do your integration and production level testing back on IBM Z. Fantastic. Any other use cases that we have?
Yeah, so one other use case that we have is optimizing storage. So when we look at this, we're talking about optimizing tape storage or disk storage by leveraging Azure Blob Storage and directing that storage into Azure.
Okay, so in that case, you're really taking an alternative approach to putting some cold storage into the Microsoft Cloud. Obviously, if you need to do any kind of analytics or any kind of data update to that, you actually have to bring that data back to the mainframe to actually do transaction processing against it.
Yes, the use case is disk optimization, but you also have the ability to have an additional or redundant storage copy if maybe it's a regulatory requirement.
Great. So these are the three patterns that we've already delivered. They're already available in the Microsoft Cloud. Looking forward to expanding that partnership as we solve more problems for our customers. I'll give you the last word.
Thank you. So we have a lot of our clients investing in both the IBM Z and Microsoft Cloud. And we walked through an example scenario today where we were solving a problem for a client. We could also help you solve a real world example for your environment. And not only just solving a problem, one of the things that I would encourage is that you look for additional capability outside of just solving a problem. Now knowing that the two platforms can interact a lot more closely, there may be a different way to look at your environment and adding additional value to your business.
Thanks for watching. Before you leave, don't forget to hit like and subscribe.